Thank you for the invitation, and I hope you had all had a short but a good lunch. Let me try to explain you a little bit more about electroseparation technologies, what we do in Fuji, particularly this time on ED metathesis. So first of all, looking to inland brackish situations, we all know that brackish water RO systems are commonly used for inland desalination, like here in Spain. With recoveries of typically 70 to 80%, meaning you have a brine stream of 20 to 30% in volume. Conventional techniques to dispose this brine is evaporation ponds, blended with well waters, or do deep well injection, mainly in the US. Already for more than a decade, the industry is looking for various systems to get a better increase of water recovery, but scaling remains a huge problem. Especially groundwater consists of calcium, magnesium, and sulfates, given problems. If I understood quite well, here also in Spain, a lot of waters here in the south containing a lot of sulfates. So maybe this is interesting topic for you. What to do? So basically, you have an RO system, one or two stage RO system, and you have this RO concentrate. And we start using this concentrate as a feed-in for the ED metathesis. So this is electrodialysis, but then with a metathesis form. And then use this to produce, again, product water and reduce the waste disposal to move to a crystallizer. Let's go back, yeah. So how does it work? You have a typical ED stack, which consists normally of two channels, but this time the ED metathesis consists of four-channel system using two different types of membranes. The standard-grade membranes, like the anionic and cationic membranes, and a combination of monovalent-grade membranes, anionic and cationic. What is the purpose? To separate the multivalent cations and multivalent anions in one process step by applying monovalent and standard-grade membranes. This results that you can concentrate up the brine, avoid scaling of magnesium and sulfates precipitation. So actually what you do is you concentrate up in two different streams. And that's why you can go to higher grades in concentration without scaling. Of course, this is tested. We tested this under the ZELDA project, which is a live project. We did this with partners as Abangoya, CTM, and WSTP. This was done in the period July 2015 to June 2017, where we're using an EDM process, then brine purification system, brine concentration unit, this was done by Abangoya, and also evaporation system. The project goal at that time was to recover valuable salts. So that was the main purpose. This was located in Almira desalination plant. And we used a pilot system with a single stage ED pilot stack with a capacity of 0.5 to 2.5 cubes per hour. It was a fully automated batch-wise system. And the stack was about 50 by 50 centimeter, 300 cell pairs. Which membranes did we use? We're using the type 10, that is our commercial grade membrane, used for regular potable water desalination, and the type 16, this is a pre-commercial membrane, and this is monovalent type grade. On the right-hand side, you can see what's the difference between standard grade and monovalent membranes is. With standard grade, all valent ions go through the membranes, the water not, that's really particular for ion exchange membranes. With monovalent, only the monovalent are transported through the membrane instead of the multivalent ions. Now, what's the big advantage? If you look into the feed water composition, in this particular case, it was a high level of sulfates inside. By using this ED system, you can produce product water, and in the meantime, you concentrate up two different streams, and you can see in concentrate number one, there is a high level of sulfate, so there you concentrate up the sulfates, whereas in concentrate number two, you concentrate up the calcium and the magnesium in a high level. That, in that way, you don't get precipitation. Now, we tested this in Almeria for about 1 year, and you can see here the water recoveries and the concentrations. So we got up to 163 grams per liter in the concentrates in two different streams. Now, what is the project results? So we see that the volume reduction of the RO brine is by a factor of 5, as well as the brine stream concentration by a factor of 5. So volume and salt concentration. Separated in two different streams, sulfate and magnesium rich. No scaling observed during pilot for 1 year, with a water recovery of about 80% and a power consumption of 5.1 kilowatts. What is the limitation of this technology? You need a surplus of monovalent anion and cation ions in the feed stream. If that's not the case, then you have to dose sodium chloride addition to the feed stream to keep the mass balance. Then it still can work, but of course it will impact the energy consumption and the water recovery. What's the benefit of the technology? High concentration process for sulfate and magnesium-rich waters to separate in processes, and extremely low wastewater volumes. Now, looking at this concept, what can you do with it besides regenerating salts? Because that was the main goal in Zelda. Looking to most inland brackish water desalination municipalities across the world, is they want to increase water recoveries because you have a scarcity. So if we can increase recovery, means higher water income and lower brine disposal cost. Therefore, we conducted several lab simulations for brackish water brines with a conductivity range between 20 and 2 millisieverts per centimeter, based on a recovery range of 70 to 80% as a typical example. To understand what could be the recovery of a hybrid using brackish water RO plus EDM. What could be the concentration factor and what could be the energy consumption? Because I suppose most EPCs would like to know that type of information. So we made two different simulations, one using that you try to make a product water of 2 millisiemens, and the other one is to make 0.5 millisiemens, let's say potable water level. There you can see, depending on the feed stream where you start, 5 or 10 millisiemens or 20 millisiemens, the total energy what you need is between 2 up to 14 kilowatts per cube for the different settings. So the brine concentration factor is between 10 and 28. Below you can also see the simulated water what we used for the simulations. Now then, what does it mean if you're looking to a brackish water site, for example a 10,000 cube per day plant? Assume they have a recovery of 70%, meaning 30% brine. You have a feed in of about 10 millisiemens. You go to 2 millisiemens production. The EDM water recovery is about 96.5. So together with the 70% of the brackish water RO, you end up in 99% total water recovery. So only a brine of 1%. If you go higher in recovery in the brackish water, of course, the water recovery goes up to 99.3. Of course, you can also think, I want to go to drinking water level, let's say the 0.5 millisiemens. You still see that you are in this 98-99% recovery range. So, conclusion. The EDM technology is ideal for scaling risk waters. It's suitable as a hybrid, so a kind of bolt-on technology onto existing brackish water sites. So, because you don't, you can use the same pretreatment, all those things already in place. The concept is can be achieved water recovery of 98-99%, which increase your water income and reduce your disposal cost. So EDM technology is suitable as a non-thermal pre-concentrated technology for salt recovery. So actually what you do is you could replace the evaporator. Go directly to a crystallizer if you want. brain concentration factors between 10 and 28, energy consumption between 2 and 15, depending on feed parameters. That's it. So I try to be short. I think questions will come later, maybe. So.
Thank you.
Okay.